All right, to do.
To do.
Felix and Chez.
What's wrong? Your footwork is even sloppier than usual.
You noticed that, huh? It's nothing. There's just been a lot on my mind lately, is all. And I was kind of lost in thought when you lunged with me, so I couldn't really react to what.
Training isn't a time for idle contemplation. You're worthless as a sparring partner if you let your mind wander. Not to mention when you do the same thing in actual battles. Getting distracted when you're training is one thing. Do it out there, and the enemy will cut you down without hesitation. We've been through this before. If there's something on your mind, just come out with it already.
Tell.
I was just thinking, you have a pretty good read on me now, too.
It was obvious something was wrong from the way you were fighting. And this is just payback from last time, so no complaining.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not.
If you say so. There's still something I don't understand. Where did you learn to fight like that? You clearly don't move like a knight. I've never seen a mercenary use those techniques either.
I guess you could say I taught myself. I didn't really have one teacher who showed me everything. If anything, I just kind of picked stuff up as I moved from one band of mercs to the next.
That explains it. I was wondering why your style was so hard to read. Both knights and mercenaries use a standard set of battle-tested tactics. Both they all play by. But you're not bound to any single convention. I suppose that's what I found strange.
Probably doesn't help that I don't have to draw my sword like everyone else. When I think about it like that, it might have been for the best that I taught myself instead of subscribing to a particular school of thought.
A unique style all your own. Fascinating. Teach me.
I'd be glad to, but I'm the only one who can use my sword. It won't be easy to replicate.
That's for me to decide. If nothing else, I can adapt your moves for my own purposes. The more styles I know, the better.
If you say so, I don't know how this is gonna go, but I'll do what I can. Oh, and you can teach me in exchange. The more styles, the better. You fight sort of like a knight, but also sort of not. I mean that in a good way. I'm not sure how to put it. It's almost like you react to the situation as it plays out. So, yeah, if we can combine our two styles somehow, I bet we'll both end up stronger for it.
Maybe so.
Alright, those are for conversations. Not Mercedes and Chez.
Mm-hmm.
Today's training was a total mess. You're killing me.
You need to stay in peak shape, though. You never know when we might get tossed into a battle.
True. We've got to be ready for anything.
Mercedes, you daydreaming again? I've got to say, you've been acting all kinds of weird lately.
Have I? I feel perfectly fine, I assure you.
You sure? Back when we had that tea party, you looked so, I don't know, sad.
I suppose I can't hide anything from you. Things like tea parties with dear friends, or seeing the trainees work so hard to improve. It reminds me of how things were before the war. If just for a moment.
You mean back at the academy?
Yes. And before that, when I lived with my mother and my little brother. It also reminds me of the time I spent studying with friends at the School of Sorcery in the capital. Things may not have been easy then, but I would give anything to return to those days.
Huh. I don't think I've ever seen you get this sentimental about something.
The feeling surprises even me. All my years, I've gone wherever the current of life chose to sweep me. In truth, I used to think nothing ever went precisely how I wanted it to. But looking back now, I realize just how joyous all those moments really were. And yes, I'm aware it isn't good to dwell so heavily on the past, but I can't seem to help myself.
And that's totally fine. There's nothing wrong with getting sentimental. Nobody's gonna judge you for reliving one or two good memories every now and then.
Thank you, truly. You're such a kind person.
Still, you shouldn't keep all your emotions bottled up like that. You might not go back to the peace of the old days anytime soon, but we can still have tea parties. I'm always here to listen if you ever need to get something off your chest, Mercedes.
You mean that? I'm so glad to hear it. In that case, why don't we have one right now?
Sure, I don't mind. But...
because I used the money I've been saving up to buy some more ingredients. Remember how we were talking about all those different kinds of delicious fruit desserts before? Well, I went ahead and mixed them up.
I could never turn down an invitation like that. Can't wait to see what you came up with.
All right.
Dude, I swear to God, Mercedes was just made for fucking Dimitri. Like, pairing up Mercedes with any of the guys, like, she straight up just, I don't know, just makes them feel better for it. Because definitely some of the guys in, like, the kingdom have, like, fucking baggage. Like, I'm talking baggage I never seen, like, normal men should have. Like, holy fucking shit.
Are we supposed to stay away from Flynn?
Good day, Shaw. I am thrilled to receive an invitation from you.
Dude. When Seth finds out, he's gonna be pissed.
The fuck?
It's like, you son of a bitch. So, like, remember the comic where I think it was Dorothea asked how she keeps her hair like that, and she's like, oh, I have a fish.
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 Though I still have my share of everyday concerns, I remain the very picture of health. When my mother was still alive, we used to live a carefree life, somewhere not far from a sea. Let me think. people occasionally claim my manner of speaking to be eccentric. Do I not speak as everyone else does?
Seth is gonna have a fucking knife in my fucking dagger, like, fuck you doing, my daughter.
Thought I told you stay away.
Way. When I said it more. Let me go to the chore master. I'm gonna talk to Seth more.